Hey everybody, it's Melanie Knight here. I am a marine biologist and a consultant and an aquarium founder and an educator. So I am here to talk to you about becoming a marine biologist. I know you want to be one. Everyone I seem to talk to is always like, I wanted to be a marine biologist when I was young. And then I'm always like, what happened? Why didn't you become one? And they're like, I don't know, and then blah, 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 something about how they, you know, just decided to take on something else, or, you know, they just forgot about it, or maybe they didn't think they were going to make any money. Okay, all of those excuses are terrible. We're going to put those away, because if you have an interest at whatever age you're at, I'm mostly considering that this is for younger kids, but hey, whatever. Whenever you're finding this video, great. If you are interested in becoming a marine biologist, don't give up on your dream. That's the whole point of this series. Don't give up. It's amazing. Become a marine biologist. The caveat, though, is that you won't be able to find somebody who is a marine biologist on their business card. Okay, that just probably doesn't exist. It doesn't say that on my business card. I call myself a marine biologist because I went to school for marine biology. I teach and work in the field of marine biology, and so therefore I call myself that, but most people don't. That's why it's really hard for kids to look up to adults who they think could be a marine biologist but don't call themselves that, and therefore they don't necessarily know what a job looks like or what their career might look like. They don't know necessarily how to get into the field, and they don't necessarily know what their future holds. You know, am I going to make any money? Is it going to be interesting? Am I going to be in the water all day? Or actually, am I going to be in the lab all day and I'm less interested in that or something? I want to caveat this whole thing with the fact that marine biology is a very large field, and becoming a marine biologist means a lot of things, and it can mean the very best thing for exactly what you want it to be, if you know what I mean. It can be exactly what you want it to be. Okay, so this is a 10-part video series. This is the first one in the series. Here's the plan. We're gonna go through 10 different things that I think it's really important to prepare you for your career in marine biology, to help you understand and navigate where you might fit within the large field of marine biology and ocean exploration and, you know, marine science, all those kinds of things. All right, let's do it. Okay, the first one is what I like to call the Venn diagram. I know this is weird, but okay, you know how you take two circles and you overlap them, and then like space in between is like it's like the Venn diagram. Most people are interested in the oceans or marine science, and they're like, I want to be a marine biologist. But the best thing in how to link your marine biology skills and interests is to actually have a different interest that you can combine with it. So for example, my Venn diagram is marine education. I love teaching people about stuff like this. I love teaching kids about nudibranchs and lobster, pea holes, cucumbers, and getting people to touch a sea star for the first time. I love that kind of stuff. And that's how I found myself within a marine career that I really love, is that I took marine biology or the ocean, and then I paired it up with something that I'm good at and that I like. I would encourage you to find your own Venn diagram. So for example, this can be any combination. People who love science, who are very technical, who love, you know, exploring, taking things apart, dissecting things, or always like looking really closely at stuff. Great. Maybe that's your research brain and you're going to apply it to become a marine biologist. And that's actually what most people think a marine biologist is, that they do research. And having said that, that's true. That's a big part of the field and a very important part. But there's people who have applied their marine biology skills and interests to a myriad of different types of careers and opportunities. A dancer or a writer or a photographer could absolutely apply all those artistic and creative skills and still partner them up with a marine biology career or interest. So being a journalist, a photojournalist, or an actual writer for National Geographic, Canadian Geographic, any of those big magazines, writing for TV, all of those types of things are really important, and you can take your skills that you have in writing and apply them. I could go through lots of different examples, but I think you get what I'm saying. Ultimately, I would encourage you right now to draw two circles on a piece of paper, go, two circles, and then figure out what your two key interests is, probably marine biology or maybe marine science or oceans, whatever it is that like you want to hone in regards to the oceans. And then what's your other circle? What's the other thing that you do really well that comes naturally to you that you love doing if you are bored? What is it, that thing that you gravitate to? And it could be video games. Okay, so for kids that are watching that are like, well, I always just watch, like I play Fortnite. I don't know what that is. Fortnite plus the oceans could be a really interesting Venn diagram. There are lots of robot engineers and remote operated vehicle pilots and submarine pilots who have amazing hand-eye coordination because of their video gaming skills when they were young. And they now are applying that same type of interest to their ocean skills, which is them being able to explore the deep sea and even potentially creating VR games that allow people to go underwater without getting wet. Doesn't matter what your interest is, and it does, and there could be multiple circles, of course. You could have multiple things that you want to loop into your marine biology Venn diagram. But for now, just write two circles and see what the first thing that comes to mind. It's important to be able to stop and think about that first, because marine biology is such a big field. If you're thinking about a field in science or research, and that's really not what floats your boat, like it is for me, it's not really what floats my boat, then you could kind of get quickly pinpointed into a place that you're like, oh, this isn't really worth it. I don't really like that idea anymore. And I'm not going to become a marine biologist, or I'm not going to continue with my studies in science or engineering or math. And I think that is key, that you find something that you can pair it up with, and then it's all worth it. Then you're going to math class with a new reason. You're going to your biology class, your chemistry or physics class, it's a tough one for me, right? And you're looking at how it matters to you. Okay, well, I can take that physics and I can apply it to how, you know, how a VR game would work if I was going to take people underwater, or how the physics of scuba diving, how that keeps me alive when I'm underwater. All those kinds of key things are really applicable once you have a clear understanding of what your Venn diagram is. Make sense? Cool. So that's pretty much it. So activity number one, find your Venn diagram. Let me know in the comments below what you think your Venn diagram might be. Share this video if you have other people in your life who are thinking about a career in marine biology, or who have always mentioned in the past that they've always wanted to be a marine biologist. Love to hear from you. This is video number one. We are going to have 9 more coming along the way. Please subscribe to the channel in order to get the next month. See you soon. This is a scuba diving symbol for okay. Not, this means up. So don't give me the thumbs up. Give me the, well, I guess there's a good thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. But that just means we're going up in diving. So it's confusing in the YouTube world. I wish they gave like an okay symbol, which was like, okay, we're all okay. And then it was like, you okay? And it was like, yeah, I'm okay. Bye!